All right, here we are for round one. We are on the draw, and I think this hand is just fine. Casts all of our spells and cords for quite a bit pretty quickly, so if he's some sort of combo deck, which it looks like he. Well, he's either a combo deck or a Delver deck, I suppose. I guess it's more likely that Delver would want to probe on turn one. Like, the combo deck would almost never want to probe on turn one, but people like to cast probe anyway. So I can imagine anybody who has probe in their deck just casting it on turn one, regardless of whether it's right or not. Yep, okay, Delver. Well, I don't really want to give him the information that we drew this thicket, so. And I think, like, it's likely that I'm going to fetch a forest with this anyway, ultimately, so I'm just going to go ahead and do it now. Like, we'd have to draw two more thickets to get punished by this, and this is, marginally hide some information. Might cause him to overvalue the bird or something. Alright, Electrolyze revealed. So, this is one of those ones that's tough to win. Usually, if their Delver doesn't flip right away, it's pretty winnable, but if it flips on turn two and they're on the play, things get really nasty. I think I actually should have fetched this one now that I think about it. Drawing the thicket makes it more likely that I want to fetch just a swamp. Alright, so he went top with his Serum Vision, which, again, definitely a horrible sign. And fork bolted our guy. Alright, there is the first Razor Verge Thicket that we can draw to help punish us for fetching on turn one instead of playing a thicket. I don't think we're going to win this game anyway, though. Like, our opponent had pretty much a very good draw. And Treasure Cruise would just completely bury us. I will not be sad when that card leaves the format, which I fully expect to happen. Alright, probe again. So next turn we can cord for two, which doesn't do a whole lot. I wonder if Skylasher maybe should make an appearance at some point. Alright, that's pretty awkward. So, yeah, if we had the Verdant Catacomb still, I'd definitely just evoke Shriekmaw here. I'm pretty sure whatever we do is gonna get, it's gonna get remanded. So, that would be fine if we had a swamp, which I'm pretty sure I should have fetched differently. As is, I don't really want to take two damage, but I don't really see a way around it. I'm just going to do it. If he has mana leak, like, yeah, we get mana leaked. That would be unfortunate. If it's just remand, we can do it again next turn at least. It'll only be at seven. I think we're probably going to get burned out anyway, but. Oh, that actually worked. That's lucky. Well, I guess we'll just pass here and then we can cord for, something good. If he goes to electrolyze us, I think we just cord. Well, we could cord for spirit now. And that would stifle his electrolyze unless he has another bolt. Probably has a bolt. Yeah. I think that's actually fine though, because then we can cast Revel Arc next turn, so I'm just going to do that. Oh, Jesus. Well, that's really horrible for us. Didn't really expect that one. It's got to be only a one of, but it's definitely bad for us. Alright, here's the cruise, as expected. Yeah, I strongly dislike the effect that this card has on Modern. I think it basically ruins the format. But I'll try some more things to adjust, if possible. Like, Thalia would be okay against this deck. The problem is that, like, they're still just going to spend 2 mana to kill it. The synergy, like, the problem that all of these cards just happen to have synergy, like, all of the cheap answers happen to have so much synergy with Cruise is really problematic. I guess we have to fetch here because we really have no choice. Can't imagine that there's not, like, a Snapcaster or something waiting for us to finish the job. Well, that's an okay draw. It gains us a couple of life, at least, assuming it doesn't get countered. This puts us to 4. Spell Snare. Alright, that's pretty bad for us. And Snapcasters. Any Snapcasters. No, not dead yet. Not sure whether we evoke or just cast Revel Arc. I guess we'll just cast it. Even though I kind of would rather have Ooze be in play. No, I think just casting it is fine. I don't think there's much chance it resolves, so it doesn't matter all that much, but he's just slow rolling us. Okay, now we're dead. So, for sideboarding, I like Abrupt Decay. I actually like Thoughtseize quite a lot against this deck, because they're so threat light that if you can just Thoughtseize away their threats, you usually win. I didn't see if he was playing Young Pyromancer, but I'm going to assume he is, in which case that's good. Thrun and Sigarda are both just excellent. I think Linvala is probably not great. Spellskite's good. Pride Mage is not great. The whole Melira package is really not very good in this matchup. And same with Cord, especially if they have Spell Pierce. And I'd love for him to leave Spell Pierce in, so it's good to do things that maximize. If your opponent, like, I don't want to get blown out by Spell Pierce, basically, so it's best to take that card out, even though, yeah. I think he should board Spell Pierce out, but he might not, because a lot of people just don't. And then Dismember's good. What do I think is bad? I think Pod is not great. I also don't like the second Sin Collector very much. I think Pod's not great just because it's kind of expensive and deals you damage when your life total is really at a premium, so I usually board out one or two, especially because you don't have a combo that you're assembling. Like, you can win the game pretty easily with just Kitchen Finks and whatnot. One more card, Wall of Roots. Just doesn't have a high enough impact. All right, let's try it like this.